Good morning. Shalom. May God's peace be with you this morning. This week we are looking at one of the fruits of the Holy Spirit, that is joy. Now in these times of uncertainties, pandemic, and looking at the economy downturn, the many issues we face in life today, how can we look and talk about joy? This joy I'm talking about comes from the Holy Spirit. It comes from the Lord. And so as we look at it, we can face our trials with joy. I've known of many friends who have lost their job, take a pay cut, no increment, yet we can see that there's joy in them and they live their life with joy, to the fullness of joy. You know, many will feel that joy comes together with material things and financial stability. In John chapter 15, verse 9 to 11, the Lord tells us that love and joy is perfected in Jesus Christ. As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandment and abide in his love. These things I have spoken to you, that my joy may be in you and your joy may be full. So joy is one of the fruits of the Holy Spirit, and it comes directly from the Lord. We cannot buy it, nor can we pretend that we have it. Joy comes as we abide in Christ and as we walk with Him. The joy that comes from Him will not fade away. It is not the same as happiness. Happiness comes when we receive something that we wanted, or when we found something we had lost, a new job or even a good meal. As time goes by, or when we face issues in life, it will fade away. However, joy that comes from the Lord stays within us even when we face various trials and testings. We can still rejoice as we find joy in the Lord. And finally, in Nehemiah chapter 8 verse 10, he tells us that the joy of the Lord is our strength. When the Lord is in your midst and in the storms that you are in your life, it will not shake you. And the joy will carry you through your life and your trials. I'd like to close this time with a testimony. Recently, my son Joshua left his job at the end of 2020 to try his hands on some new business venture. Personally, as a father, I feel that it's not the right time and I counsel against it. Yet, he felt this is the opportunity that he had. And so he left his job. The business venture did not take off and he found himself jobless. And I told him, the only thing we can do now is to ask the Lord to open up doors of opportunity for him. And as we prayed, especially with the pastors, the Lord opened the door and Joshua got a job. In less than 2 weeks, he received a job interview and he started work immediately after the Chinese New Year. In this case, we can actually have the joy of the Lord, that this joy, that this situation that Joshua have encounter, it brings him closer to his God. And our God that we all worship together will carry us through the joy that He gave us. I would like to pray with you this morning, even as we close. Father, we thank you for bringing the joy into the lives of your children. May your presence be with us and may your joy be our strength as we go through the issues of life, in Jesus' name. Amen.